The launch date for Flight 11 has been pushed back further since our last update. Is there a serious issue? How is SpaceX addressing this delay? Furthermore, SpaceX isn't the only company attracting attention. Blue Origin has quietly revealed the anticipated date for New Glenn's maiden flight. The problem is, that date coincides quite closely with the scheduled launch of Starship. Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. In the last update, we noted that Flight 11 was originally scheduled to launch on October 6th, which is only a week away. There was significant excitement and high expectations surrounding this. However, recent information has changed expectations, causing a mix of disappointment and curiosity. The United States Coast Guard has issued a new notice to mariners, officially delaying the launch period by 1 week. The new target launch date is October 13th to 19th, with the launch still scheduled for the afternoon around 6:15 p.m. Texas time. The notice states that October 13th will be the primary launch day, while other days will serve as alternates. Due to this delay, Flight 11 will now occur approximately 6 weeks after Flight 10. While this seems relatively quick compared to typical Starship launch turnaround times, many had anticipated a shorter interval due to the overall success of Flight 10. This unexpected delay has raised questions about the reasons behind SpaceX's decision to delay the launch. One possible explanation relates to concerns that some of the heat shield tiles may have loosened or become dislodged during ground testing due to intense vibrations. To address this, SpaceX reportedly had to replace and reinforce these tiles, especially since the spacecraft introduced a new crunch wrap technique, which involves wrapping each tile to seal joints and increase durability. If this is accurate, the reason for the delay becomes clear. While this may be frustrating, it underscores the company's dedication to ensuring Flight 11 will be performed with greater reliability. There may also be a more beneficial reason behind the timing. If SpaceX launches on the key scheduled date, October 13th, it will coincide with a significant anniversary in the Starship timeline. October 13th marked the fifth flight, a landmark mission when SpaceX successfully captured the B-12 booster with its Mechazilla arm for the first time. This achievement paved the way for practical reuse of Starship boosters, resulting in three successful captures since then, two of which have been reused, including B-15, the booster designated to fly on the 11th flight. This situation has sparked curiosity. Is SpaceX possibly planning to commemorate the fifth flight's anniversary with another attempt to catch a booster? If B-15 is successfully captured, it would become the first booster ever to be retrieved twice. Although it seems unlikely that B-15 will be utilized again due to SpaceX's shift to updated models, accomplishing this feat would secure its legacy as an iconic booster. However, this is still just conjecture. From the available data, Flight 11 is anticipated to adhere to a strategy akin to Flight 10, but it will bring additional difficulties. The booster is expected to re-enter at a steeper angle, and SpaceX is likely to persist in evaluating low-engine landings. These objectives imply that an ocean landing is more probable than a mechachilla catch. Nevertheless, unexpected events have always played a role in SpaceX's narrative, making it conceivable for a catch attempt to occur. No matter the ultimate choice, the extended timeframe affords SpaceX substantial chances to finalize preparations. S-38 remains in the inspection phase, with installation processes expected to conclude within the week. Conversely, B-15 seems to be at a more advanced stage. Its hot staging ring was placed on September 20th, and the flight termination system may have already been installed, either at the launch site or during its transit to the Rocket Garden, where it is presently situated. Simultaneously, modifications are taking place at the launch pad. On September 26th, the chopsticks were elevated, and a crane was utilized to take down the ship test stand, also referred to as the ringwall stand or star tool, which was subsequently relocated to Sanchez site in the early hours of the 27th. Following this, SpaceX plans to deconstruct the ship QD frame and related fuel pipelines, which will also be transferred to Sanchez. The current inquiry is what SpaceX intends to do with these components once they are removed. Pad 1 is approaching the conclusion of its usability for ship testing, with future operations likely to migrate to the new Pad 2. Static fire tests for ships are expected to transition to the Massey site. This situation leaves the existing ship testing infrastructure with uncertain destinies. They might be discarded, upgraded for utilization at Massey,
stored in the bays for future assistance, or simply maintained for emergencies. Each scenario exemplifies SpaceX's ongoing cycle of experimentation, repurposing, and innovation. Returning to the orbital launch mount, SpaceX still must place the hold-down clamp arms before B-15 can be moved to the pad for final integration. After this step is achieved, B-15 will go through the last preparation stages, clearing the path for Flight 11's introduction. The work on the booster and pad is likely to be completed by late September or early October, providing ample time before the mid-October launch window. This time cushion allows SpaceX to meticulously inspect, test, and bolster every component. Instead of hurrying, they can guarantee that Flight 11 enhances the success of Flight 10, pushing Starship further toward dependability and reusability.
Thus, while the initial schedule delay may have been disappointing, it also created an exciting prospect. SpaceX is attempting booster recovery, with Flight 11 being significant as the final mission before moving on to the next version of Starship. Heat shield upgrades, engine reliability assessments, booster landing difficulties, and pad modifications all contribute to a mission that will likely bring the program closer to achieving its ultimate goal. Despite the long wait, excitement remains. Flight 11 has the potential to reveal surprises, achieve milestones, and provide valuable information that will impact the next segment of Starship's journey. If you're curious about what's behind it, show your enthusiasm by commenting. We're always supporting, and don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on SpaceX's incredible journey. October is certainly shaping up to be a memorable month. Not only with the highly anticipated Starship Flight 11, but also with the possibility of another long-awaited launch, Blue Origin's New Glenn. After numerous delays and rumors, Blue Origin recently gave the clearest indication yet that New Glenn 2 is on the way. This operation is a significant one, as it will transport NASA's Escapade spacecraft destined for Mars. For Blue Origin, the stakes are incredibly high. In a recent update shared on XB, Blue Origin confirmed the arrival of the Escapade spacecraft at its Astrotech Space Operations Facility in Titusville, Florida. There, it will await integration onto the New Glenn rocket. Simultaneously, the mission's designated booster is expected to reach Launch Complex 36 in early October, where it will undergo a vital static firing test planned for mid-month. Blue Origin has even shared images of the New Glenn booster proudly displayed inside its massive manufacturing facility, heightening anticipation. The company concluded its update by stating that if the test goes well, the New Glenn's maiden flight will be imminent. This creates an exciting moment in spaceflight history. In mid-October, we may witness a symbolic rivalry between two companies often considered partners, SpaceX and Blue Origin. Their rockets, Starship and New Glenn, are not only among the largest and most powerful vehicles currently in development, but also embody two very different approaches to the future of space exploration. The pressing question is, which rocket will launch first? Currently, all indications are that Starship Flight 11 will lift off before New Glenn 2. The Starship launch schedule has been announced. Preparations are proceeding steadily, and the main launch date has been set. Meanwhile, the New Glenn launch schedule remains unclear. According to the latest information from Blue Origin itself, the rocket won't even conduct a static fire test until mid-October. As keen viewers can see in the Blue Origin image, the rocket still lacks an engine assembly. After the static fire, there are still many complex steps to complete, such as second stage stacking, payload integration, and final inspections. Even if everything goes smoothly, these steps will require additional time. Furthermore, there is always the risk that New Glenn will experience technical difficulties during its significant maiden test. Therefore, for those closely watching the competition, it's safe to assume SpaceX will be the first to launch. If you agree, express your support for Flight 11 by posting F11 in the comments below. Nevertheless, even if Starship takes the lead, the New Glenn 2 mission remains a significant achievement. That's it for today's episode. See you next time.